Hello. Good morning. Welcome to Space Engineers again on the Xbox One. I'm still on it, still playing it, still enjoying it. This was my survival save, which I've converted to a tutorial world. You might recognise it if you watched my first part where I set up my small base. The base has since expanded with lots of resource gathering and building. And I found cobalt, I've found silver, I've found a bunch of other things. That's not what I wanted to talk about today. What I wanted to talk about is what you could consider a pitfall of Space Engineers. Something that people may or may not know about. Veteran builders will know about it. People who have experienced it will know about it. What am I talking about? I'm talking about trash cleanup. Oh, yes. If you're new to Space Engineers, this is a pitfall that you may end up falling into and losing a beloved build. Let me explain. When you have a certain amount of objects, Space Engineers performs a trash cleanup. It will remove them. And it starts with floating objects like pieces of stone or bits of broken ship. And it moves on to grids. And it looks at this grid and it goes, does this grid have power? Yes, it does. It has power, it has power storage, and it is doing fine. I don't need to remove this grid whatsoever. Does this grid have power? It's on a landing gear, it has a battery, and it has a cockpit, which is busy doing stuff. If that cockpit had a light, it would be draining the battery. The battery at the moment is kind of okay. Let's go back over here. I'm going to show you something. This is a landing gear, attached to a battery, attached to a cockpit, with a light. This is not going to recharge the battery, even though the landing gear is locked and connected to the grid and built. Look at the battery. Let's have a look, shall we? Fully depleted in 4 days. So, 4 days' time, that battery is going to turn off. That grid will become unpowered, regardless of the fact it's connected to the base grid. This is because landing gear do not charge grids. What does charge grids are rotors. And a lot of the veteran builders of Space Engineers I've picked this tip up from, including the wonderful Paul Thompson. I'll link his channel in the description of this video. The rotor will actually charge your grid. So if you're going to build a new ship, especially a small grid, you could start by building a big rotor like this, grinding off the rotor head, and then using the control panel to add a small head and build off that. Because if we go into this, you'll see the battery, which is a different colour because it's on a different grid, it's called a subgrid, is fully recharged in 3 hours. It's pulling power off my base with these wind turbines. To basically provide constant charge to that battery and the ship connected to it. All well and good, you might ask, but what happens if there's no power? If your battery runs out and it's not connected to a grid? Well, if we hop into the cockpit of this ship and we turn off the power, then we jump out. Nothing happens. That's because we have not gone away from the grid. If we fly over here about 500 meters or more, we're looking for ore. Got our ore detector out on our drill. We're bouncing around, looking around, looking around. There's some ice. We find the ice. We go back. Well done. May have found other things, magnesium, nickel, cobalt. back. Come back. Oh. Our ship has gone. That grid is no more. Disappeared. Forever. And if you haven't blueprinted it, or you are halfway building a rover, or a spaceship, or, clang forbid, a large grid ship, then that will be gone. The same as this. If this here, even though it's connected to my base, in 4 days' time, depletes the battery, and that battery shuts down. When I go 500 plus meters away from this base, that has gone. This will stay. Because as I said before, it's constantly charging the battery. Hopefully, this video has been some use to you. It's one of the pitfalls you can learn to avoid, especially by building on a rotor or having a sufficient power source on your grid when you do it. And that's all for this particular video. So, stay safe, take care, have fun, happy engineering, enjoy yourselves. Until the next one, bye for now.